How strong is a wolf? Compared to other canids, one of the most successful groups of hunters in the world is the family Canidae. That's right, canids. And existing in the world today, there are around 37 different species of canids. That's a lot of vicious, angry species hunting down their prey. Billions of hungry mouths with trillions of teeth across the world, but when we look at them all, who's top dog? Is it the wolf? He is often crowned as king of the canids. But is he really the strongest of them all? Or does he have a competitor out there that might just overpower him? Wolves. If you're a fan of Game of Thrones, you know dire wolves were fierce. Some of the fiercest canids that ever lived, but that species is now extinct. However, living right alongside them were gray wolves, and they somehow managed to continue on as a species. Perhaps they were better survivors, more resourceful. There are some others out there who rival the size of the gray wolf. The question is, do they rival the strength? If any other canids want to challenge a gray wolf, they better be confident in themselves or step carefully. How quickly you can step foot into a gray wolf's territory. Their territory can range from 50 square miles to 1,000 square miles, and they defend those territories ferociously. They'd hope to just scare away anyone infringing on their territory, but if it needs to be a fight, if it needs to be a fight to the death, then so be it. Gray wolf packs have been known to confront one another over territories. Fur has flown, teeth have bitten, blood has been shed. And these wolves are extremely muscular, sometimes 6.5 feet long, usually over 120 pounds, sometimes up to 180 pounds, able to run at speeds of up to 37 miles per hour for long distances. Their bite force is 1,200 pounds per square inch, and a pack of 4 to 7 wolves will regularly take down 700-pound elk and even 900-pound moose. So, if another canid is going to try to rival a gray wolf, it better come packing a punch. So, do we have to look any further than the gray wolf's own backyard? Coyotes. Gray wolves can be found in Europe and Asia, but another area where they are extremely prevalent is North America. But they are definitely not the only predatory canid on that continent, because coyotes are found all throughout North America. Coyotes are the reason many cat owners and dog owners don't let their pets stay outside past sunset, because these carnivores are everywhere and they're extremely opportunistic. Coyotes are about 4.5 feet long and rarely exceed 50 pounds. Weight advantage and size advantage goes to the wolf, but don't go thinking a coyote isn't powerful and doesn't have a strong bite. Over 700 psi for a bite force, and a very successful pack hunter. Coyotes and wolves occupy a lot of the same areas, and coyotes have been known to kill wolves, maybe in a dispute of territory, maybe because the coyotes wanted one less predator to compete with over prey. However, that's only in the case when the coyotes have a wolf significantly outnumbered. What happens far more often is that gray wolves have killed coyotes, and they don't need the numbers on their side. They can do it 1-on-1, 4-on-4, even if they're outnumbered only slightly, because a gray wolf is far stronger than his little cousin of North America. They've killed them to show their top dog in North America. Sometimes they even eat them after having killed them. If that doesn't show dominance, what does? Foxes. Let's give a quick shout out to the foxes of the world, present on every continent except Antarctica. These are extremely successful predators, and they're the worst nightmare of rats, mice, and other small rodents. And though a rat looks up at a fox with fear in its tiny eyes, a fox may look up at a wolf in the same manner. Let's not get it twisted, foxes are extremely successful predators because the ones that share continents with wolves are smart enough to entirely avoid the wolves. Although wolves seek out much larger prey, when food is scarce, they'll look for smaller animals. And now the wolves and foxes are competing over food. The wolves don't like the competition, and they'll kill foxes in their habitat. And sometimes, after having killed their competition, if food is still scarce, they may just eat their competition. The biggest foxes rarely weigh more than 30 pounds. They stand no chance against a wolf. African wild dogs. From a continent that gray wolves have not visited, a new challenger has stepped into the ring. And this one really has a chance. African wild dogs are not as big as gray wolves, but they are the next biggest wild canid in the world today. We know gray wolves can reach 180 pounds, but more commonly, they're around 100 to 120 pounds. An African wild dog can weigh as much as 80 pounds and be around 4 feet long. But the way they're built makes them bulkier than a gray wolf. They're more solidly built, and they're extremely tough. They have a few advantages over the gray wolf. They're faster, hitting speeds of 45 miles per hour. They're one of the more aggressive canids, and they're one of the most successful predators in the wild, with a kill rate of around 85%. So, if our African wild dogs get a taste for gray wolf, that wolf may be in a lot of trouble. African wild dogs are different from wolves and other canids who often go for a chokehold or kill bite. They tend to latch onto limbs of their victim, allowing the other dogs in the pack to latch onto other limbs, and then they all tear the victim apart. The African wild dog would hold his own against the gray wolf. He's extremely strong, and they are extremely efficient with their pack hunting. Their packs also range from 7 to 40 individuals. If it's pack versus pack, pencil in the African wild dogs for a win. If it's an even matchup, we could see it going either way, but the gray wolf still gets the edge. Dingoes. Let's bounce to another continent to find another canid that a gray wolf has never laid eyes on. In Australia, we have the dingo. This is an interesting one for a few reasons. One, the dingo is regarded as a feral dog by many, since their ancestors were domesticated dogs. What does this mean? It means that dingoes are less aggressive than many other wild canids, as they don't have that mentality of living in the wild ingrained in their brains for as many centuries as others do, like wolves. Less aggression means you're slower to jump into the battle, and if you hesitate for a second, a beast like a gray wolf would surely destroy you. Dingoes generally weigh between 25 and 40 pounds, so they're quite oversized. But here's the interesting wrinkle. It is believed that dingoes have a bite force of up to 1,500 pounds per square inch. If that is true, then that is actually stronger than the gray wolf's bite. You should view a dingo as a boxer with a puncher's chance. The gray wolf is the favorite, but just let the dingo get one good bite in, and he may end that fight in a matter of seconds. If a gray wolf was unlucky enough to roll up on a pack of dingoes, he may be in for a world of hurt. Dingo pack numbers are generally higher than gray wolf pack numbers, so if two packs met in the wild and a fight ensued, don't expect all the dingoes to live. But don't expect that every gray wolf will live either. In fact, they might all fall. Jackals. Now, we're going to cover a wide area, Africa, and also parts of Southeast Asia, home to many kinds of jackals. And you may be surprised to know that there are jackals that rival the size of wolves and are just as strong, and do at times defeat them in battles, which sometimes leads to death. However, in this case, we're talking about black-backed jackals of southern and eastern Africa and Ethiopian wolves, a much smaller kind of wolf. However, if we head to the Middle East and parts of Asia where the golden jackal and gray wolf do have some overlap, you likely won't see many jackals defeating wolves. Jackals are not as large or strong as other canid species, especially not the gray wolf. However, have you ever watched a fight and the stronger individual didn't win? That's how a jackal could defeat a gray wolf. They're not only one of the more cunning canid species, they're known to be resilient and rarely give up. Jackals have figured out how to take down antelopes that are far bigger than themselves with the help of packmates. If they wanted to take down a gray wolf, they may just figure out a way. Even if they were being dominated by the wolf, that resilience kicks in. We won't say a jackal is stronger than a gray wolf, because that is false. But we also won't tell you that they'll lose the fight. Dholes. Dholes also live in Southeast Asia and have some overlap with both the golden jackal and the gray wolf. Bite force quotient is something used to measure the strength of an animal's bite relative to its size. Among canids, our past challenger, the African wild dog, he has the highest BFQ of 138. The gray wolf is next with 136. Right behind him is the dole with 132. So even fight between the two, right? Sure, if they were the same size. But the fact is that dholes, although vicious and successful predators, are much smaller than gray wolves. They're about 3 feet long and 30 or so pounds. So if something extravagant happened and a particular dhole grew to 6 feet long and weighed over 100 pounds, yeah, he could potentially dismantle a gray wolf. And though dholes take down prey 10 times their size and their packs sometimes steal kills from tigers, if a dhole took on a gray wolf, he'd be done for. Domestic dogs. Let's start by saying, most domestic dogs are smaller than gray wolves, they aren't as strong, nor are their bites, and they're domesticated. No chance. However, let's take a look at some of the biggest domestic dog breeds that exist. For instance, a Canid Comparison, Kangal Shepherd dogs, and English Mastiffs. Canid Comparison can weigh 120 pounds, and Kangal Shepherd dogs can weigh 130, right in line with what average gray wolves weigh, and quite possibly weighing more. Both dogs have bite forces of 700 pounds per square inch or more. Canid Comparison are strong, as are Kangals, who have also been tasked with protecting livestock. An English Mastiff may have a lesser bite force of around 550 pounds per square inch, but that's still strong, not to mention they can weigh over 200 pounds. An important note is that all of these dogs are domesticated, so they aren't as aggressive as a gray wolf, and they don't have the same instincts. But they do still have those protective instincts, and they can rival the wolf in both size and strength. Give any of them a situation where they need to protect their owner from the ensuing gray wolf, and those protective instincts will kick into overdrive. And there you have some of the best challengers to the gray wolf. Not alone Canid Comparison, Kangal, or English Mastiff, but a Canid Comparison, a Kangal, or an English Mastiff that has a reason to be protective, that has a reason to play defense to the offense of the gray wolf. Because in that situation, that strength laying dormant inside of them for centuries could bubble to the surface, and the wolf may not like what he's gotten himself into.